Hello everyone and welcome to Usitility. Today we are going to see how to play Rise of Cultures on PC using the brand new BlueStacks 5, that is designed for blazing fast speed and high octane action. It packs a punch with mega performance upgrades and it has faster performance than any other high-end Android device or Android platform. We will be able to easily download and install Rise of Cultures and enjoy the game on our Windows PC with keyboard, mouse and big screen thanks to BlueStacks 5, which is the Android emulator that we recommend to play Rise of Cultures. So without further ado, let's get to it. Before anything else my friends, the first thing to do is to launch our favorite internet browser. We open the one we use by default. Let's continue, going to this URL that I'm highlighting in green color. There you are seeing it on the PC screen. There is no need to type it, because there's a link in the description of this video in the first main comment. We ended up at this point on our website of Usitility, at which we have a meticulous demonstration on the best way to download Rise of Cultures on computer. We search lower a bit and simply click on the Download Game on PC button. Once clicking on that link, we get to the website of BlueStacks, which the Android emulator that we will use to get access to this game Rise of Cultures on the PC. As you can see here we access some advantages of preferring the emulator. So we are on the way to proceed to download the Rise of Cultures by clicking on this button Play on BlueStacks that I have marked in green color. We then click on the button. Of course, the download step starts and ends immediately. Here it is, here is located the download. It's a file we have to execute. The following step is to launch the installer, okay, then we click on this file. Windows 10 users will be asked for permission to allow changes to the device. We have clicked yes. I minimize the web browser to see the installer better. The installation software is very easy to use. It consists of two possibilities, install and setup path. I am going to make it clear what setup path genuinely does. We basically just click on it. And therefore we realize that we get here the path where your emulator can be installed. If we would you like to change for better this folder we must click on this browse option, and now we choose another folder and install the emulator wherever we prefer. To keep it simple, just leave it where it is. Then, I click on back. Therefore I just click on install. Fantastic, the install starts and it will progress with the download of all these MB that happens to be displayed on that computer screen. After you download it, it could possibly be a little bit more or less megabytes. The download rate could go faster or at a lower speed, based on your connection and according to the data transfer rate of the emulator web servers. Now they're working superbly fast. The download is finished, and now it proceeds with the installation phase. With BlueStacks 5 you can even reduce RAM usage with a single click. Especially useful if you ever face performance-related problems. In addition, you can activate Eco Mode to enjoy 87% reduced CPU usage, 97% reduced GPU usage and easier multitasking. As you can see, BlueStacks 5 is built to provide stability and performance during long gaming sessions. The installation has already finished for me. At present, the emulator has actually been launched instantly. As you can discover, at the bottom of the screen, there is a progress bar that will move forward to the right and when it has reached the ending, the emulator is launched for the very first time. The fact is that the emulator is already launched, here it is for the very first time. Before we keep going, as can be seen, it has created two app icons here on the computer desktop. The BlueStacks and BlueStacks multi-instance. Note that the BlueStacks app icon is going to be the one we are concerned with. When we want to launch Rise of Cultures on our desktop or laptop, we twice click this app icon and as a result use the emulator. The BlueStacks multi-instance icon allows you to launch multiple emulator instances. And with BlueStacks 5's new improved multi-instance manager in Eco Mode, players can run more game instances faster and with less lag. Shall we make the next step, which is a must-have, and that is to visit the Google Play Store. And we are going to mouse click on Play Store. As you understand the Google Play is presented. Here we need to log on. Presently the moment we are here, we must absolutely do this next phase that is definitely mandatory. Therefore we just click on, sign in. Presently it announces, checking info. It can from time to time get stopped at, checking info, and it fails to continue. In this case, you should try to log in after a number of hours and it will usually be sorted out. At this time we can enter our email and password. The email really needs to be a Gmail email as well as its corresponding password. For instance you can utilize the exact same email you use right now in your YouTube account. So that I am going to insert my info and I will revisit immediately after I have accomplished it. Voila, information entered. This is Google welcoming us and presenting us the twos. We must say yes to them simply by pressing, I agree. Following that, it allows us to back up to the Google Cloud. You can keep it checked and this will generate a backup of the files on that device to Google Drive. I won't select it, you can use that option if you want. We click accept. Google Play, formerly Android Market, is started by default and instantly. To set up the game, we would need to get to the emulator desktop for Android by clicking on that app icon designated in green. At present that we are exploring the desktop of the emulator, we can see that we have there the install app game option. We click on that button. Listed here we come with the game. Why don't we mouse click here on the install choice that I'm just presenting now in green. That click will launch the installation. At this moment it is going to install the Android game, it typically takes a while or it might well be extremely fast. It all is determined on our connection to the internet. This has as of now finished setting up. It's time to go back to the emulator desktop by simply clicking this button I'm highlighting in green, if you want to use Rise of Cultures for the very first time. You are presently on the emulator desktop, and we're on the way to click on the fresh Rise of Cultures software icon that has been generated. Your Android game is launched for the first time on your machine. Here we have it. I am able to mouse click anywhere on the screen and also make use of the keyboard. I have to talk about the volume of the emulator. This is here. We use the icon of higher volume along with the icon of lower volume. This manner we will not rely on the Microsoft Windows volume to increase or decrease the sound of the emulator. And also to appreciate the experience to the fullest, we can activate the big screen, for which we have two alternatives. This one is simply the first one. We click on that icon which I am basically designating in green. Thus the display screen is maximized, getting one border on top, one on the right side and the third one at the bottom. In case that we choose to appreciate the game using all the screen, we hit that software icon. And we might already be enjoying the gameplay in full screen function. To stop the complete screen mode, click the F11 key. And we'd by now be in standard screen setting. At present, I am on the way to reveal you the keyboard mapping and that is surprisingly cool. That way we may be in a position to utilize the game a lot more easily. The very first task is to click this keyboard icon. And at this time there you will have the ability to make the necessary setups. I am going to let the normal settings, but if you wish to adjust that, you can do it now without any problem. Clearly, the emulator is fully in our language. From time to time it occurs that the emulator is presented in the erroneous language, such as, in Chinese. And thus to set it up in the right language we click here to the cogwheel. And thus right here within other configuration settings, we click on the language drop down. We are able to go with the language we need, English, Japanese, and so forth. When the language is chosen, we could save, the emulator would restart, and also the game app, the next time we start it, would as well be in the preferred language. Presently, you will find another aspect that we must take into consideration, and it is that we will get a message from Google telling you that a new machine has been associated with our own Google account. It will question us if we are the people who have associated with that device. Indeed, we really should not get worried, considering that the emulator is behaving like in Google Android smartphone or tablet. So you can determine which device is being emulated, we visit here, to the cogwheel and we mouse click on it. Let's browse here to the model option. And here we realize that the emulator is emulating a Samsung smartphone. And so we're going to receive an email saying that a new Samsung device has been connected to our Google account. This is it guys, so much for the tutorial. I hope that you liked it, especially that everyone thought it was useful. In that case, allow it a great like, subscribe, and if you have remarks, issues or suggestions, leave them in the comment area below. You could also leave comments on my Twitch channel, I actually do live streams on occasion, you get it down below in the video description and in the first pinned comment. Check out any of the video tutorials that are appearing on the computer screen and see you in the future video game videos. Bye.